Welcome to Link tutorial. My name is Nitish and in this part we are going to learn about the where operator. So first we will see what is where operator, then we will learn how and where can we use where operator, and then we will create multiple examples of where operator in both the syntax, that is query syntax and the method syntax. So first let's understand what is where. Where comes under filtering operators. So as in the previous part we have seen that in the filtering operators there are two methods. First one is the where and the second one is the of type. So in this part we will learn about the where operator. Where is used to filter specific data from a data source based on a condition. Where always expects a condition. So basically where is a method which is used to filter the data from a data source, and there should always be at least a single condition in where operator. You can write more than one condition as well, or you can write only one condition based on the requirement. Condition can be written using following symbols. So basically if you are writing a condition or more than one condition, then there are certain symbols that you have to follow. Let's see what is that. Equal equal. So basically if you need to write your condition something to check the equality of two things. So suppose from a data source of employee you need to fetch only those records whose salary is equal to 50k, then you can write this symbol that the salary of employee should be 50. Then we have greater than. If you need to fetch those records whose salary is greater than 50, then you can use this symbol. Greater than equal to, if you need to consider the equal record as well, it means you need to fetch those records whose salary is greater than 50 and equal to 50 both. Then less than equal to, or. So basically this is the symbol of or condition. It means if you are writing more than one condition in your where method, so and you need to fetch those records who satisfy at least one condition, so you can use or operator in that scenario. We have and operator now. So AND operator basically is used to combine multiple conditions. It means if you need to fetch all those records who satisfy all the conditions which are written in the WHERE method, then you can use AND operator, etc. So there are multiple operators as well, but these are the most common operators which are used in the WHERE method. So now let's see some examples of WHERE method. So now here I am in my Visual Studio, and in this Visual Studio I have a very simple console application. In this application I have a program class and then I have a main method. In this main method, first of all let's create some data source. So suppose the data source is list of integers. So this is our data source. I have a list of integers which has 10 elements, 9 and 10. And now let's understand how can we use where operator in this data source. So suppose for a first example I need to fetch all those numbers which are greater than 5. So let's see how can we do that. So we will write the query method. Query syntax is equal to from number, any number in, then data source. What is the data source? The name of data source is data source. Now we will create a condition. So after from you will write your condition, you will use where method. Okay, where. Now just see for the example, in the data source it has a list of integers, and what is available in the number, number is the type of integer. So it means all the number will be available in number one by one. So if I need to write some condition, then I will compare it with the number. So I will write like this, number is greater than 5. So I am going to fetch only those records who are greater than 5, and then I will select number, and that's it. And if you need to execute your query at this place, then you can use toList method as well. So I will enclose this query in a single bracket, and then I will write the toList method here. Now this query will get executed at this place. So first let's put a breakpoint here and we will see what is the output of this query. So press F5. So let's see, query syntax has 5 records, and what are the records? 6 7 8 9 10. And what is the type of query syntax? It is a list of integers. Let's see, It is a list of integers because we are fetching the integers and then we are converting those to a list by using toList method. Now let's see how can we do this in the method syntax. So where method syntax, you know how can we write the syntax? First the data source, then dot, and we will use where method. And for where method, you need to provide at least one condition, and to write a condition in where method, we use lambda expressions. So how can we write that? So suppose num such that num is greater than 5, and then what will I do? I will use toList method, and this query will get executed at this place. If you do not want to execute this query at this place, then you can ignore toList and simply you can use foreach loop. In that scenario, this will also work very well. So first let's press the F5 and see what is available in the method syntax. You will see method syntax also has 5 records, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, which are greater than 5. And you can see in the query syntax as well that the result is completely same. Now, let's use some other operators as well. So this is greater than. In place of greater than, I will use less than in both the conditions. So now, what should be available in the result? There should be 1, 2, 3, and 4 because all those numbers which are less than 5. Now let's press F5 and see what is the result. So you will see the number is 1, 2, 3, and 4. In the method syntax as well, what is the output? 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now, let's see how can we use other operator. It means, suppose I need to fetch less than equal to 5. So I will use this operator, less than equal to. And now let's press F5 again. Now there should be 5 elements, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, including 5, because we have written equal to as well. So 5 will also be there. So everything is fine. Now let's see how can we write multiple conditions. So number is less than equal to 5 or number is greater than 9. So now I have written two conditions that only those records in which number is less than equal to 5. So what is less than equal to 5? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, and number is greater than 9. So what is greater than 9? Only 10. So in this case, we will get the result of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 10. So let's see how can we do it here in method syntax as well. We will simply write or number is greater than 9. Let's press F5 now. So you will see it has 6 records. What is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and the 10, which is fine. And now let's go to method syntax. What is available in the method syntax? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 10. So this is fine. So using this way, you can write your multiple conditions. Let's go with the another example. Now let's create one more data source of string. Here I have created one more data source which has a list of a string, and now let's perform some operations on this list. So for the query syntax, how can we do that? From, suppose this is str in data source, and we are going to select str. Now we will perform some where conditions. How can we do that? Where str dot. So all the methods which are applicable to string will be applicable to this str. So string of length is equal 3. So we will get only those records whose length is 3. And we have only one record of this type because the length of term is 3. For a while, let's comment this method syntax and let's press F5. So you will see in the query syntax, we have only one record. And what is that? Term. So we have only one record because of the condition. So the condition is that length should be 3. Or if we need to write our condition like, so instead of length, suppose I directly want to apply my condition that I need to get only term record from the data source. So I can do this as well. So string should be term. So let's press F5 and you will get only one record in which term is available as a result. You need to write multiple conditions, then write OR operator and then str dot length is greater than 4. So now let's see what is available as a result in this query. In this query we have four results. First one is Tom, because we have written one condition that the record should be equal to Tom, and then we have used OR condition. In OR condition, what is the length of Harry? It is 5, then counting, it is greater than 4, and then Sachin, this is also greater than 4. So you can write your condition like this. If I change the condition, it means I do it like greater than 5, then you will see there will be 3 records. Because Harry, the length of Harry is 4, which is not considered, which is not satisfying the condition. So this is not the part of the result. So let's see how can we do that in the method syntax. Data source where, let's remove this part, str, and then such that str dot length is greater than 5. So there is only one condition in this query. Let me press F5. And you will see what is available in the method syntax. There are two records, Ponting and the Sachin, because the length of these strings is more than 5. If you need to write multiple condition in method syntax, then you can do that as well by pressing AND OR condition. Or so basically OR is just the example. You can write AND as well, and str equal equal Tom. Let me press F5 again, and now you will see what is the output. So there are three records. The first one is the Tom, because we have one condition which is saying that the string should be equal to Tom, and as for the second condition, then the length of the string should be greater than 5, then for that part we have two records. So as a result we have three records. Now let's go with some more complex example. Let me remove this part completely. And I have created a class which is employee class. This employee class has four properties, and the fourth property is the programming property, which is a type of list of tags. And what is available in the tags? Tags has only one property, which is technology. So we will create a data source for this class. So you can see our data source. This data source has five records, and all the five records have some technologies as well. So first record, which is Tom, has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 technologies, and the second John has three technologies, then the third Mark has two technologies, and the last 4 and 5, both the records don't have any kind of technologies. So suppose from this data source I need to fetch those records who has no technology. So let's see how can we do that. First let's go with the query syntax. To write a query syntax, we will write a variable query syntax, and then simply from str, or you can write emp, because you should always write some meaningful name in your query. So if you write employee, then it will be very easy to recognize that what is available in the emp. But instead of emp, I will write the employee complete, emp employee in data source. And now let's create the where query, where emp employee dot employee dot programming, and then we will write a condition on this part, the count, because count is a method of list. The count is equal equal 0, and we will select the employee, select employee, and to execute this query at this place, what we will do, we will write the toList method at the end of this query like this. So let me press F5 now. So you will see there are two records, and the type of both the object is employee. Let's see what is available in the first one. First one has Kim, because the ID is 4, and that Kim don't have any kind of technologies in his stack. Let's see what is the next record. Next record is of ID 5, and this is true, because both the records of ID 4 and 5 don't have any technologies with them. Now if you need to write, suppose I need to get only those records where technology is equal equal 2. So who has technology 2? The record number 3, ID number 3, because it has only two records, link and MVC. Let me press F5 again. So now you will see we have only one record, and it is a type of list of employee. And what is available in this record? There is only one record, and the type and the ID of the record is 3, and the type is employee. If you need to write multiple conditions, let's see how can we do that. Simply write and employee dot suppose id equal equal 4. So I'm doing it like this, that the count should be, the count of the programming should be 2 and the id of employee should be 4. So you will see the result 0, because we are writing two conditions, and as per our conditions we are using AND operator, and there should be some record which is satisfying both the conditions, and in our case we don't have any kind of record which is satisfying both the conditions, because the two count of programming is available with id 3 and we are writing one more condition in the AND that the id should be 4. So we don't have any kind of record in this scenario. So what is the output? We have a list of count 0, we don't have any kind of record. Let's try this thing in the method syntax. So where method syntax, how can you do that? First data source, then dot where, and what we write in the where, we write the variable, then such that employee dot programming dot length dot count is greater than 3, and then at the last we will write toList method to execute this query. What is available in the method syntax? There is only one record, and what is that? ID is 1. So basically, and the programming, it has 5 programming skills. So we are writing a condition which has greater than 3 programming skills. As in our data source, we have only one records which has more than 3 programming skills. So that is record number 1. So which is correct. Now, if you need to add some other condition as well, that let's create one more condition. If I'm using OR, employee dot name equal equal, what should be the name? It should be Kim. Now let me press F5 again. So you will see it has two records. First one is the first record, because of the first condition in which it is satisfying that the programming skills should be greater than 3, which is correct. And as per the second condition, we have one record that the name of the record should be Kim. That's why we have two records in this scenario. Using this way, you can write your where method and you can filter data from the data source. That's all in this part. If you like this video, please subscribe the channel and hit the like button. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.